AFTV, Talia, smiling, must be happy. We're just beating Bournemouth 4-0 at Bournemouth. Really convincing performance today.
Yeah, I agree. I think that, I mean, I was positive before the game and I'm obviously positive now. Yeah, it was nice to see. I think I said earlier, it was nice to see us not come away with just 1-0, but to come out with 4-0. I know two are penalties, but they're still goals. It's nice to see us finally starting to dominate.
What do you think was different today? I mean, obviously the North London derby, we had a little bit of disappointment leaving the ground. A lot of fans did, rightly so. Today it felt a little bit different. It felt more controlled. Why do you think that was?
I know this is going to sound quite simply put, but it felt like there was an actual football team out there today. Mm. I know that's it's kind of a bit of over the head comment, but when we were playing Spurs, it was very disrupted still. And today it just felt that there was a lot more structure to what was going on. And there was, again, there just seemed more confidence in the players around each other.
Mm. Listen, there's a few standout performances today. I just spoke to James and it was hard to pick a man of the match. Who stood out for you?
Yeah, it's interesting because we were saying that there's quite a few maybe different people that could have been a man of the match. But I think for me, it was definitely Martin Odegaard. Mm. Yes, he doesn't obviously, some games he's not on form. But, you know, statistically, he dominates and he's good. He's good. You know, he's good at what he does. And he definitely, you know, he was able to get, you know, together with so many different the goals that happened today. So,
Yeah, absolutely. Listen, it's hard not to look at other results, but we always do it. Manchester City dropping points. I mean, seriously, we've got Lons to go first, so we've got to concentrate on that one. But in terms of the Premier League, I think it makes it even bigger now next weekend, would you say?
Yeah, I agree. I mean, it was always going to be a big game next week anyway, but I think it does. And I think, you know, that's the thing. We needed this confidence boost today. We needed to be like, okay, we can do this. Mm. And I think some of the players needed it, especially someone like Havertz. Maybe he needed that. And even Smith Rowe, I know there were those two misses at the end, but, and I know obviously it would have been amazing for him to get them, but these are kind of things that might start giving people a bit more confidence, not just the, well, the players, yes, but also the fans. Mm. I think the fans sometimes need a little bit more confidence.
Fair play, man, fair play. Listen, we've spoken about Kai Havertz and we've spoken about Eddie Nketiah today. What's your thoughts on both of these guys?
Oh, that's a good one. To be honest with you, I don't mind them. I don't mind them. Look, I wouldn't put them in my starting 11. I mean, I'm not a manager, but I wouldn't. I don't mind them. I think they're great people to probably sub on when you're in the game already. But yeah, I wouldn't start them. I think that, you know, obviously someone like Eddie, you know, last season out of nowhere, he was incredible. And again, there's no point looking back all the time and always looking forward. But, you know, he is there and it does come through sometimes. That's why I said I wouldn't put him in my starting 11, but he still does pull through sometimes. Someone like Kai Havertz, I don't know, I'm keeping quiet from that one.
Do you think this can do a lot for his confidence though now? I know that goals come in, only a penalty is a well-taken penalty, by the way. I think everybody wants to see him do well. I just think there's a lot of doubt. And me personally as well, I think a goal maybe now we look and see if there's anything we can see from him, a little bit of confidence boost maybe.
I think that this is almost the test. It's like if he can now really pick up this confidence and start to play, you know, football in a very specific way, then yeah, this is kind of what it's going to be. This is why we got him. But this is like I said, this is the test. It's we're going to see, is he going to start making something here or is he not? I'm hoping he does because, you know, I'm just hoping he does because at the end of the day, he's a footballer and it would be nice to see him doing this. So hopefully the goal does give him some more confidence.
And just lastly, last player to talk about, Raya and Ramsdale. It keeps going on this debate, different goalkeeper every game. David Raya didn't do anything wrong today, did he?
No, he didn't. And that's the thing. I think, I don't know if you saw the press conference. One of the journalists asked Arteta, which player would be starting, in goal beginning with an R. And Arteta was like, I'm going to start using that for the rest of the season. And I was like, fair enough. That's a really good answer. Because, well, that's the thing. It's like, you can see what's going on with Ramsdale. I always liked Ramsdale, but now we're seeing Raya and I just feel more confident when he's there. I really like Ramsdale and always have, but there have always been little mistakes that I've seen and I just kind of think, how has that happened? Where someone like Raya, I don't know if those mistakes are going to come as far or kind of as few and as far. So yeah, I think we can all see where this is going, but I guess we have to kind of wait and see it out ourselves.